The first time I actually realized that art could be something was my grade 3 teacher. He said, hey, you're good at art, you should become an artist. And I didn't know what that meant. She said, no, you can work as an artist. I said, like a living? She said, yeah. And I thought, that'd be pretty cool. I was brought up because my mother was Dutch, so we were brought up with Rembrandt. Because that was like, we had painting, like prints of Rembrandt around the house. But I when I went to art school, I was more gravitating towards Monet. But Monet's impressionism is really Rembrandt. Rembrandt was really, he was an impressionist painter. He was probably one of the first impressionist painters. When I first started being an instructor, it was more of a party atmosphere. People would come there to drink wine and paint. So only maybe a third of them are interested in painting. The other ones are there because their friends dragged them there, and the other people are there because it's a way to just socialize and have fun. Teaching art here is different because people want to be here. And so you're getting that one third of people who want to learn, now it's 100%. It feels cool to be able to take them through that journey, it's a place where they start and show them all the little techniques they can use and then watch their eyes light up and they go home and practice because they not because they have to practice, no homework here, but they practice because they want to do it. That's satisfying, that they actually take what you teach them and then they have questions. We start with watercolors,
yeah,
which is unusual because they have to bring watercolor paint, but they also have to have acrylic paint for when we do the acrylic part. So it's 6 classes, 3 watercolor, 3 acrylic. And the first 2 in watercolors is really just learning techniques. First one is showing just all the basic techniques, and then the second class was doing a waterscape using a wax technique, where they learned using salt technique, just the basic watercolor techniques, and doing a sort of a surreal painting. And then there was more of a landscape painting. Doing landscapes, the first landscape they did was very like a wash type technique, very dreamy. And the other way we can also do watercolors is with a structure, like a pen and ink, a dark penning, and using it. You can paint over the lines, it's up to them, but they go from unstructured to structured, showing that there's the different variations, different uses of watercolor. And acrylic painting, it's just, we just did, if they just copy what I did as show them how to do a painting, or do the same next time, and probably the last class is that they could probably bring in their own photograph or whatever reference they want, and use that as what they're painting. But I'll show them all the basics, and then I'll just go around helping them as they go. Hoping that the biggest problem I find with people doing art is they have fear of art, because they fear of making mistakes. And with acrylic, if you make a mistake, you can paint over it. So I'm hoping that they get over some of that fear.
Of course, here would be similar structure.
Similar structure, it might be broken into a watercolor class specifically and an acrylic class specifically, but it's the same basic premise. Mm-hmm. Depending, and of course it depends if you get a whole bunch of people in there and half of them are you know, not really beginners, I can actually break the class down into 2 groups again, mm-hmm. and treat them separately, mm-hmm. or just run them through that they want to learn the basics from. But it's similar, it'll be the same sort of, mm-hmm. and the same goal,
right.
to keep them entertaining, keep them wanting to create.